Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your girl, Miss P. I hope that you are doing fabulous today. I am doing well. I did want to give a big shout out to the Huffington Post. What's up, y'all? How y'all doing? I'm waving. Wave back at me. Okay. All of these new reality shows, starting out with Tamar and Vince. I am really enjoying Tamar and Vince. One, because Vince is a hustler. He does his job. He does it well. Tamar, don't say that, Tamar, because Tamar, I need you to calm down, Tamar. But his voice got a little bit deeper this season. His chest, when we see him on the Braxtons, he real calm, cool, and collected. On this one, he like, girl, this is my show. Tamar is very, very extra, but I love her because she don't play. I do enjoy her song, Get Your Life. And I can't wait for her to actually put out her record because we've been waiting for it. I love Tamar. I love me some Toni Braxton. That's my Toni Braxton. All of these new talk shows, honey. The Steve Harvey Show. I actually watched a little bit of the Steve Harvey Show. It's just okay to me. I want him to... I feel like when I watch his show, I want him to do stand-up. Because I'm sitting there like, tell a joke, Steve. And everything he says, the audience starts laughing. And I'm like, oh my God, how not authentic can we be? I'm just a little confused with this show, the people that he has on the show. He kind of needs to break the ice. And I think it would be a good show once he breaks that ice and once he finds his niche, because he's just like, okay, I got a talk show now. Let me see what I can do. I want him to actually, I don't know, talk. Sit down. Like, give it to us. I really think they pushed it out too fast and they didn't really have a premise for the show. They were just like, the Steve Harvey Show. And he was like, yeah. Honey, Ricky Lake is back. That was before my time, okay? I'm only 22, and when Ricky Lake was hot, I think I was like 6. So I'm sitting here like, Ricky? She looked good, though. Baby girl is fierce. And I loved her on Dancing with the Stars. But her show, I'm still trying to get back into it. Like, it's not really pulling me in just yet. The Wendy Williams Show is back on for its new season. I love me some Wendy. I love it. She's different. Everybody and their mama has been on the show. And I love how she's just herself, and I love how she's grown, so I'm definitely a Wendy Williams fan, but it come on too late for me, and then in the daytime, I'm out doing stuff, so I have to watch it on YouTube, but I still love Wendy. Okay, we have a bunch of sitcoms and music shows that I want to talk about. First up, ABC on Thursday nights. Y'all definitely need to get into the Grey's Anatomy. I love me some Grey's Anatomy. I love how it's going. Mark! Can't believe he did, Lord! Oh, Jesus, help me, help me. I don't have on no makeup, so I don't know why I'm fanning. Scandal is up with Kerry Washington. I love me some Kerry Washington. Olivia Pope, yes, honey. Can't nobody rock a shoulder pad like Kerry Washington. Yes, her shoulders be up like this, honey. Boom, boom, pow. American Idol is actually gonna be one of my favorites. I grew up watching American Idol. When American Idol first came on, I was 11 years old, and I love that show. So to still be watching it to this day, and I was really into it last season, and I cannot wait to see Nicki Minaj, Mariah Carey, Keith Urban, and Randy Jackson get it in on these people. I cannot wait to see the auditions, just to see Nicki and Mariah. I think that's great. It's great to see two females and two males, and I think that's how it should have been in the first place. Last season was really good with J-Lo, and I thought that it wasn't going to be that hot, but I actually loved it. I love Steven Tyler and I love the Randy Jackson. It was actually a good dynamic. They had some talented people up there, and I was really, really into the last season. A lot of people are like, oh my God, Nicki Minaj, why is she up there? She can't sing and blah, blah. It's for the entertainment factor. Mariah, I mean, she can do all of that, but I mean, we need some entertainment. Keith Urban, he's the country aspect, and he's just another swoosh. So, you know, they have to mix it up sometime. Same thing when J-Lo and Steven Tyler was up there. I was like, why? But it worked out. It turned out to be good. So we'll see. Real Housewives of Atlanta is coming back. I cannot wait because NeNe is the last one standing from the original Real Housewives of Atlanta because she is very rich. Okay, I want to talk about how Chris Brown done failed his drug test and the doctor actually gave him a note so that he could smoke the reefer whenever he felt like it. Christopher, first of all, Christopher is still in court. Like, didn't he do all of his community service? Here comes Rihanna sending him a tweet talking about, Christopher, I am praying for you, Barbados. I was like, Rihanna, she trifling because she's sitting there tweeting like, ooh, send this dude a tweet, I'm sorry. And we praying for you, Chris. But Chris, sir, since we're talking about Rihanna and Chris Brown, I wanted to talk about Rihanna's new song, Diamonds. I love that new song. I love the chorus. It's an amazing song. I love it. And I can't wait for her new album. Rihanna puts out bomb albums. I also want to talk about Brandy. She is in the top 10. I'm very, very excited for her. I love me some Brandy, honey. I was a Brandy stan back in the day when I had the Brandy braids, the little box braids. Yes, I did, honey. If I had a picture, I would show y'all. But I love me some Brandy. She was like actually my first CD. I love Brandy. Like, I'm a Brandy stan. Put It Down is one of my favorite songs. I'm gonna put it down. Yeah, I love that song. Everybody has heard about the airline Horizon Air. It's out of Alaska. How the flight attendant took this dude's iPad. I'm laughing because if it would have happened to me. Woo! We ain't even gonna talk about that. But I do want to say kudos to the man who owned the iPad because he had the Find My iPad app. So the dude, the flight attendant, actually took the iPad, took it home. He was, you know, changing everything, putting his music on there. There's a Find My iPad as well as a Find My iPhone. So definitely get it in. And if you have an Android or something, figure that out. The flight attendant actually said, my wife, she was the one who actually stole it. It wasn't me. And I don't know how this happened. And they were like, sir, do you have the dude's iPad? And he was like, no, I don't. The music started playing and they were like, dude, you are framed. Some people have no conscience, no character. They don't care. So that happened and it's very unfortunate. So definitely be careful when you're out and about. Definitely be careful with your cars, you by yourself with your bags. Just be careful and please be very cautious when you're out and about. Don't think everybody has your best interest at heart because they do not. And thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Peace, love, and all that good stuff. God bless.